Hey guys, so today it is time for my spring favorites. I have been just doing my favorites videos seasonally this year rather than monthly. That way I can really narrow it down to like my absolute favorites. I do have two fails to share this time, but mostly favorites. So some of these are rediscovered, some of them are new. So let's go ahead and get into it. The first favorite I have is a rediscovered favorite, and it is what I'm wearing on my eyes right now, the ABH Norvina palette. This has been one of my favorite palettes to reach for lately. I've had it for like almost 3 years now, and it's so funny, when I first got this, I didn't like it at all, but now it is like one of my favorite palettes in my whole collection. Today I went very like warm and goldeny, but I have the shade Incense in my crease, Summer on my lid, a little bit of Dazzling in like the center of my lid, Dreamer in the inner corner, and a little bit of Wild Child on the lower lash line, and then I smoked out some of that Incense on the lower lash line as well. So most of the time when I use this, I go very rosy, but today I just wanted to do something a little bit different. But the colors in here just excite me so much, like especially the metallic row on top. I love that you get one full row dedicated to just these foiled metallic shades, and they're all such like ethereal shades, perfect for springtime, and I'm just so glad that I finally woke up and realized what a wonderful palette this is. It's just very romantic, soft. I can't get enough of it. Like, if you took all my other palettes away, I would be fine with just this. Like, I mean, I'd be sad to lose my other palettes, so please don't take them from me, but that's how much I've been loving this. So I do have two other palette favorites. One of them is the Flower Jungle Lights palette. This is newer to me, and I mean, it's all foiled shades, so of course I love it. Perfect for spring. So many of these make just a great one and done lid shade. I love this coral shade here. It's so just warm and fresh. These are definitely cream shadows, sort of like ColourPop Super Shock shadows, but to me they're even more of a true cream shadow, not so much like a cream to powder, but I have been absolutely loving this palette. So glad I decided to pick it up. My third eyeshadow palette favorite is another recent addition to my collection, and it is the BH Cosmetics Summer in Saint Tropez palette. I am so glad that I was finally introduced to BH Cosmetics, and it's thanks to my friend Alex, who actually decluttered her Belgian Waffle palette to me, that I even decided to dive further into the world of BH Cosmetics and try out another palette. So let me talk about the Belgian Waffle palette first, because this one was the first one I tried. This is a face palette, and let me start by saying I am not even normally a face palette person. Like, I would not have ever bought this on my own, but I was absolutely blown away by this totally unexpectedly, especially with the highlighters. This is one of my favorite highlighter formulas I've ever tried. I feel like they are very similar to the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector highlighters, but I like them even a little bit better. I did talk about that in my recent dupes video that I can link below, but this was one of the dupes to those highlighters that I'd found. I like these better. Like, I can confidently tell you I like these even better. They melt into your skin. Even though they're a powder, they almost work like a cream in that they really just melt into your skin so beautifully. Those highlighters are ridiculous. They're so good. And then I also really like the bronzers. I especially like that there's this really light bronzer shade in here. For some people, that would probably be like a setting powder or maybe even a highlighter. But for me, that is the perfect, like, very subtle bronzer that I can't mess up. It just always looks good. I can always count on that to work for my skin. Just warms up my skin ever so slightly, especially when I don't want to look like I'm wearing bronzer. Well, I never want to look like I'm wearing bronzer, but you know what I mean. And then these two are a little bit deeper, so I'll normally mix those with the lighter one to get a little bit of a deeper bronze in other areas of my face, but all in all, just such a great palette. I've been reaching for it a ton. This shade right here, Maple, is like a very coppery highlighter shade that just, you know, it's not gonna work on my skin tone as a highlighter, but I can mix it with the bronzers if I want to get a little bit of a glow to my bronzer, since these three bronzers are matte. So, but I love this palette. Cannot believe how good it is. Sorry, I'm trying to scoot back so you can actually tell I'm wearing a shirt. Being as impressed as I was with that palette, I decided to try one of their eyeshadow palettes when they were having a sale on their website. All of their travel palettes were on sale. This one was on sale for, I think it was half off. I got it for $8.50, and it is the Summer in Saint Tropez palette. This is like my perfect colorful palette because it has some pastels, which I love. It has some brighter, richer colors that I also love, and the shimmers in here are gorgeous. These two are duochrome, and they actually perfectly replace two of the magnetic singles from ColourPop that I had to toss when my cat accidentally peed on some of my palettes. It's a long story. But these two, it was a total coincidence. I had no idea that these would be perfect replacements for two of those shades when I bought this. But Coastline and Exotic, very similar to ColourPop Glass Bowl and Tea Garden, which were two of my favorite duochrome shades that I had to toss. So that was a happy accident, but it makes me even more happy that I chose this one. I did like 3 Instagram reels using this palette in a row. It was just all I wanted to use there for a few days, and I'm so happy I picked this up. These colors offer so much variety, and it's really just everything I need in a colorful palette. So really happy about that. By the way, I'm not wearing any foundation today. I recently started using prescription tretinoin that was prescribed to me by my dermatologist. I finally went to the dermatologist. I hadn't been to a dermatologist in like 8 years, but my acne had really been flaring up and I was just getting desperate. And he did prescribe tretinoin, clindamycin, and spironolactone. So I've got just this whole trifecta of prescriptions that I have right now. But anyway, I've been using the tretinoin for just a few days now. I've only used it twice so far, but my skin was peeling so badly that I just couldn't wear foundation. Wanted to give my skin a little break from makeup, because when I do put on makeup, it just clings to all of the peeling and dry areas. So I actually think that my skin looks really good. I've only been using those prescriptions for a few days, and somehow my skin has really started to clear up. Now, knock on wood, it may just be like a fluke, because these prescriptions are really not supposed to start working for weeks, if not months. So I don't want to get too excited. But after maybe a few months, if I have some like progress to show, I do plan on filming a video about that. And hopefully by that point, I'll be able to share a good skincare routine once I've gotten this like irritation and dryness under control. But speaking of skincare, let me go ahead and quickly share a few skincare favorites, and then I do have more makeup favorites to share after this. But the Paula's Choice Softening Cream Cleanser. This is part of their skin recovery line. I had actually purchased this a few weeks ago before I started the tretinoin, and I'm so glad that I did, because this has been a lifesaver. It's so gentle. It is a non-foaming cream cleanser. I really do feel like it cleanses my skin though. It says it's for dry and very dry skin. So if you are, whether you're, you know, using tretinoin or any kind of other drying products, or your skin is just very dry, highly recommend this, because it will not strip your skin or irritate it at all. And I actually ended up just last night purchasing a couple of other products from this line, because I do not currently have a moisturizer that's going to cut it during this extreme period of dryness. So I ended up getting the moisturizer in this line and the overnight moisture mask. So I'm very excited to try those out. But I think that this skin recovery line is going to be coming in handy for me in these next few months. Another Paula's Choice product that actually just recently came out, they did send this to me, but this is their Omega Plus Complex Cleansing Balm. This is hands down the best cleansing balm I have tried so far. Fragrance-free, like all Paula's Choice products, and it is very hard to find a fragrance-free cleansing balm, so if you've been looking for one, this one is amazing. Reminds me of the Ordinary Squalane Cleanser as far as like texture, but it works way better. This removes every last bit of eye makeup, face makeup, sunscreen, everything. You will not be left with like raccoon eyes after you use this. Some cleansing balms, like the one I just used up from Burt's Bees, I would always have leftover mascara on my eyes no matter what. This, it removes everything. Like, it is so reliable. It's not super oily. Like, it is truly a balm. Like, it doesn't melt into an oil like other balms do. It's not messy, but it's so effective. It's just, I mean, I'm not surprised, because Paula's Choice very rarely lets me down. Like, almost never lets me down. And this was another just total win for me. Now, if you do want a more budget-friendly option for your first cleanse, the 4-3 Beauty BFD Cleansing Oil is a very close second to this one as far as effectiveness. Occasionally, I'll be left with just a little bit of remnants of eye makeup with this, but it really does remove 98% of my makeup. And then, of course, I always go in with a second cleanse. This one does contain fragrance. It's not a very overpowering fragrance. It's honestly just a very herbal kind of scent. And because it's a wash-off product, I don't really mind that. But this is a great option for a true oil cleanser if you don't love a cleansing balm. It breaks everything down, but it also emulsifies and completely rinses away with water. So it's not, you know, it's not like using just straight up coconut oil or something. Like, it actually will rinse away with water. So this is another highly effective option. And it is like half the price of the Paula's Choice one. So I really do recommend both of these, just depending on what you're looking for and what your budget is. I will come back to more skincare, but let's go ahead and talk about some of my other makeup favorites. So a base favorite, I won't even call it a foundation because it's technically not a foundation. It's literally called the Unfoundation from Undone Beauty. This was my favorite product that I tried from Undone Beauty. I do have a full face of Undone Beauty on my channel that I did a few weeks ago if you want to check that out. This was the winner for me. This is actually their matte tint. They also have a glowy tint, but they happened to send me the matte one. Totally wasn't expecting to like this because it is called a matte tint, but I really enjoyed this. It doesn't look flat matte, it really just looks like skin. And it doesn't look like I'm wearing foundation, but it does provide a really nice base for other products to go on top. It really offers hardly any coverage because it's truly a skin tint. Like, it's just meant to kind of give you a base for the rest of your makeup, and it does even out your skin tone slightly. But if that's the kind of product that you're looking for, I highly recommend this. I really do. I would be curious to try their glow tint as well, but I'm just so happy with this one and never thought I would like a matte base product of any kind. A concealer that I've really been loving is the e.l.f. Hydrating Camo Concealer. I wish I had tried this sooner. I was very late to the party, but I'm so glad I tried this. So much better to me than the original Camo Concealer. It's honestly so similar to the Too Faced Born This Way. Great coverage, but it looks and feels very hydrating on my under eyes, which is just kind of the perfect happy medium for me. So once I'm finished with my Too Faced Born This Way that I've been trying to pan, this will be my number one go-to. Okay, a brush favorite that I've actually had for a while, but I only recently started using this a lot, and now it is my favorite highlighter brush, but this is the e.l.f. Precision Feather Light Highlighting Brush, I think is what it's called. It doesn't have a name on it, but I think that's what it's called. This is a very floppy highlighter brush. Like, the bristles are quite long and very soft. Previously, my favorite highlighter brush was the Real Techniques setting brush, but actually this one has replaced that because I just feel like it gives me such a more diffused highlighter application. I still can get a really strong highlight with this if I want to, but I just feel like it blends it so much better into my skin and I don't end up with like a stripe of highlighter like I sometimes would with the Real Techniques one. All right, then I have two body care favorites and then we'll get into my last products that are fails. This body lotion from EOS. Oh my goodness, this is, oh, it's so good. Okay, so first of all, EOS is now cruelty-free after many, many years of not being cruelty-free. It's funny though, because a long, long time ago, I used to think that they were, just because they seem like the kind of brand that would be, you know? Like, they seem very natural. But for the longest time, they weren't, and they now are Leaping Bunny and Logical Harmony certified. Very exciting. So I was in need of a new body lotion and I decided to pick up this one. Saw it at Target. But this is their Shea Better 24-Hour Moisture Body Lotion in the Vanilla Cashmere scent. They had a few other scents as well that I would probably be interested to try next, but this scent is so good. It smells, to me, it smells exactly like Vanilla Bean Noel from Bath & Body Works. Not only that, but the lotion itself is so just softening and nourishing and buttery, and it doesn't leave your skin feeling greasy, but it does just give you a ton of hydration. Just cannot get enough of this. I have it on my bathroom counter, and I also, every time I wash my hands, I put this on immediately after because I just want to smell the amazing smell. And I feel like I've been using it a lot, but there's still so much left in there, so I think this is gonna last me a very long time. I don't usually get that excited about body lotion, but this one actually makes me excited to put on lotion after I shower. It's just such a delight, such a treat. Another body care favorite, this is another product from Paula's Choice. This is their Extra Care Non-Greasy Sunscreen with SPF 50. It says it's for face and body. I don't really like it on my face because it just kind of stings my face a little bit. So I just stick to it on the body, and on the body it doesn't irritate my skin at all. This is actually a really great value, especially for Paula's Choice. It's $17, which is cheaper than a lot of their products, and it comes with 5 fluid ounces. So, you know, really great bang for your buck, because a lot of their face sunscreens, which are only like 2 fluid ounces, I think, are like $30-something. So much better value. But this is a very liquidy sunscreen, and it sinks into your skin so quickly. It is a chemical sunscreen, so there's not going to be any white cast. It doesn't form like a film on your skin like a mineral sunscreen would. And It's a body sunscreen that I actually don't mind wearing, which is very rare for me to find. And it does live up to the non-greasy name. It does kind of smell like a sunscreen. There's no added fragrance at all, but just the sunscreen ingredients themselves do make it smell like sunscreen. But I don't really mind that because the texture and the feel on my skin is just perfect. So if you've been looking for a body sunscreen that you'll actually want to use, I highly recommend this one. Last but not least, I do have two fails to share with you. The first one is a makeup product, and it is the ABH Lash Brag Mascara. I've talked about this a couple times already, but I just wanted to go ahead and reiterate for you. Beautiful packaging. I did get this as part of a vault that I bought with the Sultry palette. Would not have bought this on my own. I didn't even know this existed. I feel like I haven't heard very many people talk about this, but it is like a $25 mascara, and it has one of those sort of hourglass-shaped wands that looks like the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara and those kinds of mascaras. I am wearing this on my upper lashes today, and I do really like the way that it looks on my lashes. It makes them very long and kind of fluttery looking, but it really does transfer and smudge on me throughout the day. I wear a different mascara on my lower lashes just to try to reduce the smudging as much as I can, and it's not too bad when I only have it on the upper lashes, but for $25, I just wouldn't recommend this at all. To me, it's just the smudging is the deal breaker, and also I want to be able to use a mascara on both my top and bottom lashes, especially if it's $25, so I just wouldn't recommend that. That is a fail to me. Now, this is a huge fail in that it is unusable. Like, I completely wasted my $7 on this. Should have read reviews online before I bought them, but I didn't. These are the Pacifica Pore Warrior Overnight Rescue Spot Dots. So these are pimple patches. Pimple patches I know have been very trendy lately, and I've just been interested in trying them. I've also been trying some from Alba Botanica that I think I like, but not enough to include in a favorites video just yet. But these I had to go ahead and talk about because the problem with these is that they do not stick to your skin. They don't stick. And the first time I used them, I thought, you know, I'd done all my nighttime skincare. I'd applied moisturizer all over my face. I thought I'd let that sink in, and then I put one of these on and it just fell right off. So I thought, okay, maybe it's because I moisturized. Maybe I didn't let my moisturizer sink in enough. So then the next time I actually tried it on unmoisturized skin just to see, it wouldn't stay on. It's like the adhesive doesn't want to stick to the patch itself. And I think what happened the first time was the adhesive actually like came off and stayed on the little strip here. But even when you have, I'm just gonna use this one because I'm not gonna use it on my face. Even when the adhesive does stay on there, it does not stick well to your skin. And if I were to try to sleep with this on, I'm sure it would just come off in the night, but I haven't even been able to do that because even just the first two times, it wouldn't even stay on for like a few minutes. So total waste of money, complete dud. This is one of those rare fails that is actually unusable. Like, I can't even try to get my money's worth out of this because I can't make them work at all. Like, they don't function. And I find that very frustrating. So, has anybody tried these and have you found a way to get them to stay on so that I can at least try to get some use out of these? And then after that, I did look up reviews and a lot of people were saying the same thing. So I was like, I should have just read the reviews before I bought them. It's just one of those things that's so easy to like grab as you're breezing through Target. And Pacifica is, you know, they try to be very sustainable and, you know, they've got like a recycling program, they're vegan. They market themselves as a very like mindful brand, but then they put out crap products like this that are just gonna have to get thrown in the trash because they don't work, which is like the most wasteful thing a brand could do. So Pacifica has been very hit or miss for me, and this might be the final straw. So those are all of my spring favorites and fails. I hate to end the video on such a negative note, but that's just the way it turned out. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up, and I'd love to have you subscribe to my channel if you've not already. And hopefully I'll talk to you very soon in my next video. Bye.